I can still remember the very first empanada I ever ate. It was this perfect half moon of delicious pastry wrapped around a savory filling. So today what I want to do is recreate that filling, and then I'm going to use Pillsbury Grand's corn biscuits. This is a new variety that has cornmeal in the biscuit, so it is perfect for an empanada. It's kind of everything you love about a biscuit and cornbread all rolled into one product. So for our filling, I've gotten a head start over here with a pound of lean ground beef that I browned over high heat with a little bit of olive oil, and then I threw in a small onion and a couple cloves of garlic. So because some of the juices have dried up, I'm going to add back some liquid so we get a nice sort of saucy consistency. I have a cup of tomato sauce going in, and then we get to season this. So today I am using just a teaspoon of paprika, nothing too crazy, and then also a teaspoon of cumin. And because I love when the sweet and savory worlds collide, I'm also going to put in a little bit of cinnamon, half a teaspoon, and then what I remember the most about that first empanada I ever had was that it had raisins in it. So a third cup of golden raisins. We'll give it a season with salt and pepper to taste. And then cut off the heat. Okay, the last thing this gets is two hard-boiled eggs. I just love that hard-boiled egg in there, so I've just got two set to go. And then if you've got one of these contraptions in your kitchen that you never ever use, it's a pastry cutter. These actually come in really handy for chopping up eggs. Once that's chopped up, we're just going to spoon our filling into the eggs, stir it all up, and let it cool just ever so slightly if it's still piping hot. Now, we need a wrapper for this savory, sweet, and spiced filling. So that's where our corn biscuits come into play. These are going to get rolled really thin, so you will need a lot of flour to help you along the way. And what we're going to do is make 16 empanadas today. So each of these gets split into two. You can actually go in here and separate out the layers like so. Once you've split your biscuits, let's go ahead and roll all of them out. Trying to keep them as round as you can. So this is about the size we're going for. It looks like a corn tortilla, basically. So we're gonna get all these going so we can set up our empanada assembly line. And again, love this dough because it just doesn't stick together. We can just peel these off. And then now we are going to go ahead and fill. Each one of these can probably hold about 2 to 3 tablespoons of filling. I have a million of these scoops around and always use them for portioning. So just give it your best guess. All right. Because we floured the board and used that to roll out our dough, I do want to use a little bit of egg wash, just as our adhesive, to help these seal up so they stay nice and folded. So just run a little bit of egg wash around, and then we can come back and fold. It's okay if you don't have perfect rounds, because we'll end up kind of crimping all of the edges, so no big deal. So you can crimp this with a fork, which is probably the easiest way, or if you like, you can just kind of do a little bit of decorative folding or pinching. Basically, any way to just neaten up the sides and tuck in our filling. And then we're all set to go. So since we already have it out, let's go ahead and egg wash these guys. Give them a nice shiny finish. All right, into the oven we go. 400 degrees until we are golden brown. All right, guys, just 10 minutes, and look, we have empanada perfection. These are beautifully shiny, golden brown. Let's see if we got nice and toasty on the bottom. Perfect golden brown and crispy. So the next time you're thinking about making empanadas, use Pillsbury Grand's corn biscuits.